59 Apple, take two.
And action.
God, please God, make the pain go away.
God isn't listening.
Matilda, how did you get in here? Where are your chains? Have they relented?
Ambrosio, I have outsmarted the Inquisition. In a few moments, I will be a kingdom away from this dungeon. My freedom came at a price. Will you pay the same, Ambrosio? Dare you cross the bounds that separate men and angels?
What have you done?
You know. My soul is not his, but his. Would you prefer to die at the stake? Burned alive with the mob looking on? Shame and infamy, not for me. I've exchanged a vague future happiness for certain happiness in the present. The spirits treat me as their queen. I have unlocked every pleasure available to me in this world. I am ready to depart, but first beseech you. I still love you and would save you from your destruction. Summon him as I did. Abandon a god who has abandoned you and raise yourself to the level of a superior being.
I cannot give up on salvation. My crimes are monstrous, but my God is merciful.
I leave now for liberty and joy.
No, you command infernal demons, bid them break my cell doors open. Please save me.
Alas, my pact forbids me from assisting a servant of God. Renounce your title and I can help.
I will not sell my soul.
Your arrogance will be your doom. You will regret it when you are burning. I leave you this book. Read the first four lines of the seventh page backwards. If you are wise, we shall meet again. If not, farewell forever.
Freeze! Drop!
And cut.
Was that good, John? Would you sell your soul if I asked you?
Okay, that was somewhat interesting. So again, we see the theme of femme fatale, the temptress. Apparently she has already convinced him to commit a bunch of crimes, because he was talking about committing, you know, sins. So maybe he has already done things and he's about to be executed or something, because she talked about burning. So maybe he's about to burn at the stake. And she offered to save him from that. Maybe. It's kind of fun with the low budget special effects. But you know, it's 1968, so you know, that kind of makes sense. I mean, okay, this guy took a long time to get out of character. In the previous scene with the rape scene, he was like very quick to drop character, but here he took a much longer time. She's talking to John Durick, not Arthur Fischer. So apparently he's not here, which is why she's so perky, I guess. I noticed... Hold on, let's go close to the beginning. I noticed...
59 Apple.
A thing, like another vibration somewhere.
And action.
But I'm not entirely sure where it was, I'm gonna have to look for it. I think it was when she appeared.
God isn't listening.
Yep, it's here.
People sell their immortal souls all the time because very few.
Okay, let's see. Let's see what she has to say.
People sell their immortal souls all the time because very few of them really believe in such a thing. Everyone knows they're going to die. Faced with their imminent death, I've seen so many turn to bargaining. Desperate bargaining. There's a panic that sets in even with the most prepared. The beauty of humanity is in its being finite. You know a rose is beautiful because it only blooms for a short while. But are surprised to learn you are roses too.
Okay, that was very short. So she's talking about mortality, and specifically she's talking about memento mori. The rose is also a symbol of Mary, the Virgin, something like that. I think so. Or maybe, I think it's a residual, like, pagan thing. From, like, sacred feminine religions. But I'm gonna have to look that up because I don't know it off the top of my head. Also, she's talking about bargaining souls. So is that how she feeds? Maybe she's a vampire who takes people's souls and possesses them, maybe, I don't know. Anyway, I want to test something, so let's go back, and I want to use this.
My heart yearns.
Yeah, I want to use the flower again, just to see if it will take us to the same place, or if there are multiple like results for the same image.
What you made me do.
Okay, there are multiple results for every image.
We get one more go with the cat, so if you want to go again, kill it before we cure it.
Scene 14-15, Charlie, take 7.
Action.
Working late tonight?
Yeah, sorry. Let me know if it's bugging you. I can turn it down.
No, I like it. I'm learning some new moves over here.
Ring, ring. Hello?
Hey, it's Maria.
Maria. Hey, what's up?
About tomorrow. I was wondering if you'd be free to do the shoot.
The splash thing? Maria, I can't do that.
You killed it at the awards.
That was singing and dancing. I can't, like, talk and act and do you, you know? What if I get caught?
So, what, it's a crime to look like someone now? They come in for the Olsen twins? $50,000 hazard pay.
$50,000? Are you joking?
I'm serious. We've done these shoots before. You stand in. This is the same, except I'm not there. This isn't like the MBAs. They're paying me a big fee to do this. You deserve it.
All right, but only because I have vet bills to pay.
Amazing. You're the best.
Maybe it'll be fun.
Of course it will. You get to be Maria all day long.
Look what you made me do. Oh, you damn cat. You hungry? Too many divas in my life.
Cut, okay, let's try it without the cat in the shot. Still good?
Oh, the cat wasn't supposed to walk into the shoot? The shot? Anyway, is that why she was looking? Yeah, because I was wondering, who is she looking at when she's doing that? But she's looking at the director, obviously this was a blooper. Okay, so yeah, Maria is employing Heather to pretend to be her for the splash commercial, which happened before the birthday thing. So we're just getting some context for the story. I don't think there's anything else that's interesting. There was something that was said in the beginning. We have one more go with the cat. So if you want to go again, kill it before we cue it. I think they mean kill the scene, kill the shot, not kill the cat. I don't know what that means. Okay, let's go back. Let's farm the flower and see what else there is. Okay, this is very old.
Hey, I want something new.
A new royal heather, ivory herb.
Beautiful soap, it's out of a dream.
A new natural soap, creamy lather, herbal goodness, for skin that never grows old.
Royal heather.
The new ivory herb.
Royal heather.
The new ivory herb from Smith & Baker.
Okay, so that must be the commercial that Marissa Marcel did at the earliest of her career. They mentioned that in the talk show, right? Here, in the talk show. They talked about it in the talk show. They said she began with a commercial. No, it wasn't here. It wasn't here. It was in the interview. It was in the interview, I'm pretty sure. When I saw Marissa... no, that was... Okay, I don't remember where I saw it. But yeah, this was definitely her commercial, and that's how she was discovered by Arthur Fischer, who cast her for Ambrosio. Anyway, once again, not much info, not much info about Marissa herself or the mysteries, but once again, let's go on and farm the flower. I don't know. I'm really... Okay, Ambrosio again.
40 Delta, take 4.
And... action.
If I need you, Miss Hilda, I will call.
Ambrosio, it is not lost on me that what passion you had for me has been exhausted. I happily give up the claims of the mistress, if I may retain those of the friend. As a friend, I see that you are upset by something.
Cut.
That was pretty cool, like a low budget special effect. Also the rose once again. So she can touch flowers and bring them back to life. Is that what it's implied here? Yeah. Okay. Back to the flower.
Terrible to say.
Two of everything.
Scene 16 Alpha, take 4.
Action. Maria?
Hey, I just got to the studio. What's up?
I need you to come down here.
What? Heather, that wasn't the deal.
I know it wasn't. I know.
What's going on?
They're asking me to swim.
That's the idea. Dive in. Splash.
I didn't realize, Maria, I can't swim.
What?
I can't. I never learned. I'm sorry. We didn't have a pool in landlocked Iowa.
Oh, the last thing we need is you floating face down in a pool and us weakly. Oh, my God. Okay, I'm coming.
I'm sorry.
Forget it. I'll be there in 40. You need to buy me some time.
How do I do that?
You're in your trailer?
Yeah.
Lock yourself in. Refuse to come out. Have a fit.
Fit?
You've seen me in action. Find something you don't like and blow it out of proportion.
Like what? Wait, Maria, like what? I'm not coming out until you bring me some new apples.
What's wrong with the apples you have?
They're not round enough.
Freeze. Mark that position for the match cut.
We have the plate.
Cut.
That was pretty funny. Okay. I'm already predicting where this is gonna go, like Apple, Eve, you know, the whole it's like the original sin, right? It's kind of funny. Also, why would it be a problem that, well, oh, I didn't catch that. Hold up. I hadn't noticed that. Oh yeah, there's something here. There it is.
Man has mastered the surface of the planet, space. But we have mastery over time. Our perspective's different. We sleep to maneuver. Sometimes because we're tired. When we take on a form, we absorb so much of its history. If you do that too many times, it can make you crazy or powerful. I've argued with the other one about that distinction.
Okay, so she's just talking directly to the camera. Where is she? Where is this place? Is this like a parallel universe space, or is it just an empty studio? She mentioned the other one. Is the other one Marissa? Like, is she communicating with her possession, or is there another vampire in the story? There's two of everything, right? So there must be two vampires. Also, what is she wearing? That looks weird. Man has mastered space, but they master time. I sleep to maneuver.
Mastery over time.
It's a very strange concept. Anyway, was there something else here to comment on? The apples aren't round enough. That was so funny. Other than that, I don't think there was anything else, I think. Oh yeah, I was gonna say, couldn't she like come clean? Like, maybe she can say, hey, I lied about knowing how to swim. Like, can we, like, use a prop or something to help me float? Like, couldn't they do that? Or maybe Maria herself had swum in another scene earlier, so... Yeah, I don't know. Anyway, let's go back to the flower.
My love for you.
I'm gonna farm this flower to the end.